Hello friends, welcome to my channel Civil Engineering MCQs. In this video, we will discuss about most important multiple choice question in design of steel structure. This video helpful for PWD, WRD, RRB, JEE, MIDC, ZP exam and it is also useful for various competitive exams. So let's start. Question number first, relation between effective length of weld and actual length of weld as per IS 200 and 2007 is. It is 4 statement. This question is asked to PWD 2018. So right answer option A, actual length equal to effective length minus 2 into weld size. Question number first, answer is A. Use this formula, effective length of fillet weld LW. LW equal to overall length of weld minus 2 into size of fillet weld. LW equal to L minus 2S. Actual length equal to effective length plus 2 into weld size. Minimum effective length not less than 4 times size of weld 4S or 40mm whichever is higher. Correct option A. Question number 2. Which of the following gradients exerts maximum influence on properties of steel? Correct option B. Carbon. Second question. Answer is B. Type of steel and carbon content. First one. Dead mild steel equal to less than 0.15%. Second one, mild steel 0.15 to 0.3%. Third one, medium carbon steel 0.3 to 0.8%. And the last one, high carbon steel 0.8 to 1.5%. Correct option B. Question number third, the ratio of bearing stress and average shear stress in mild steel as per IS 800/1984 is. Correct option D. 1.875. Number third, answer is D. This code was based on allowable stress. IS code 800/1984 specifies the permissible or allowable stress in various section. The first one, permissible average shear stress equal to tau average equal to 0.40 fy. Second one, permissible maximum shear stress tau max equal to 0.45 fy. Third one, permissible axial tensile stress sigma at equal to 0.60 fy. D equal to permissible bending tensile stress sigma bt equal to 0.66 fy. Then permissible bending compressive stress sigma bt equal to less than or equal to 0.66 fy. Permissible bearing stress sigma b equal to 0.75 fy. The last one, permissible combined bearing and bending stress sigma c equal to 0.90 fy, where Fy equal to yield stress of steel. Now use this formula, bearing shear stress upon average shear stress 0.75 fy upon 0.40 fy. So correct answer 1.875, option D. Question number 4. If the flange of certain steel rolled I section class, then as per IS 800/2007, the I section will come under the category of. Right answer option D, slender category. Number 4, answer is D. Classification of section. The cross section are classified plastic section, semi-compact section, slender, depending upon the moment rotation capacities. First one, plastic section. Cross section which can develop plastic hinge have a rotation capacity required for a failure of the section by formation of plastic mechanism are called plastic section. Second one, compact section. Cross section which can develop plastic moment resistance but have inadequate plastic hinge rotation capacity for formation of plastic mechanism before buckling are called compact section. The limits on the width and thickness ratio of plate elements are provided to classify it. The section under a particular class is third one, semi-compact section. Cross section in which the extreme fiber in compression can reach yield stress but can't develop the plastic moment of resistance due to local buckling are called a semi-compact section. The last one, slender section. Cross section in which elements buckle locally even before alternating of yield stress are called slender section. So correct option D. Question number 5. Maximum principal stress theory gives satisfactory results for. Here is the correct option B. Brittle material. Number 5. Answer is B. The principal theories of failure for a member. First one, maximum principal stress theory, Rankine's theory, it's suitable for a brittle material. Second one, maximum shear stress theory, is Gates' theory, is suitable for a ductile material. The maximum principal strain theory in ascent theory. 1. Maximum strain energy theory. Hank's theory is suitable for ductile material. Also, it is suitable for hydrostatic stress condition. Last one, maximum distortion energy theory. Von Mises and Hankins theory. It's suitable for a ductile material. So, correct answer option B. Question number 6. The cross-section area of rivet resist. Correct option A. Shear stress. Question number 6. Answer is A. The rivet is ductile steel pin with a manufactured head at one end. A straight portion is known as shank. The cross-section area of rivet resist a shear stress. So, correct option A. Question number 7. At which one of the following location of simply supported plate girder, horizontal stiffness are provided? Correct option D. Longitudinally somewhere in the compression flange. Question number 7th. Answer is D. Longitudinal stiffness increases buckling resistance of web against bending. These are provided between transverse stiffeners. First one, longitudinal stiffness provided at 0.2D from compression flange, and second one, longitudinal stiffness provided at NA. So correct option D. Question number 8. If the depth of the section of an upper column is much smaller than the lower column, then this question is asked to exam assistant town planning 2018. So correct option D. Filler and bearing plates are provided with column space. Question number 8. Answer is D. If the depth of section of upper column is much smaller than the lower column, then filler and bearing plates are provided with column splice. So correct option D. Question number 9. As per IS specification, what should be the angle of inclination theta of the lacing bar with the longitudinal axis of component member? This question is asked to exam Nagar Parichad mains 2018. So correct option C. In between 40 degree to 70 degree. Question number 9. Answer is C. The angle of inclination theta of the lacing with longitudinal axis should be between 40 degree and 70 degree. 40 degree less than theta and theta less than 70 degree Celsius. Question number 10. The effective length for patterned compression member in the design of compression member should be increased by percentage. This is also questions Nagar Parichad mains 2018. So correct option A. 10. Question number 10. Answer is A. Effective length of patterned column should be increased by 10%. So correct option A. Question number 11. While designing the fillet length for truss members, correct option A. Center of gravity of the weld should coincide with the centroid of the section. Number 11. Answer is A. For designing the first length for truss member, CG of weld should coincide with the centroid of the section. Option A is the correct answer. Question number 12. As per IS code 800/2007, the maximum width of the covered building section should preferably be restricted to how much beyond which suitable provided for the expansion joint may be made. So correct option B, 150 meter. Question number 13. How maximum size of fillet weld is obtained in the case of weld applied to the round toe of steel section? Correct option A, 3/4 of the thickness of section at the toe. Question number 13. Answer is A. Maximum size of fillet weld S max, first one for a square edges S max, thickness of thinner member minus 1.5 mm, highest quality of structural steel section are readily available from rolling. Second one, for rounded toe of rolled section, S max equal to 3/4 of thickness of the section at the toe. Question number 14. In the design of gentry girder, as per the guidelines of limit state, what shall be the value of impact allowances of vertical loads in the case of electric overhead cranes? So right answer option C, 25% of maximum static wheel loads. Question number 14. Answer is C. Additional loads for a structure subjected to impact. First one, types of load, and second one, impact allowances. Vertical loads transferred to the rails. First one, for electric overhead cranes, 25% of maximum static wheel load. Second one, for hand operated cranes, 10% of maximum static wheel load. Second type is horizontal load transferred to the rails. For electric overhead cranes, 10% weight of the crab and weight lifted on the crane. For hand operated cranes, 5% of weight of the crab and weight lifted on the crane. Third one, longitudinal loads along the rails, 5% of static wheel load. So correct answer option C. Question number 15. The strength of compression member with helical reinforcement dash times the strength of similar member with lateral tiles. So correct option A, 1.05. Question number 15, answer A. Helical reinforcement column gives 5% more strength than column with lateral ties. Question number 16. Which one of the following gives the slenderness limit value so as to ensure lateral stability of simply supported beam? Correct option A, 60B or 250B square upon D, whichever is less. The slenderness limit values to ensure lateral stability. First one, simply supported beam, lambda equal to 60B or 250B square upon D, whichever is less. Second one, cantilever beam, lambda equal to 25B or 100B square upon D, whichever is less. So correct option A. Question number 70. If the permissible value of stress in tension on a section through a throw top butt weld done in shop is 150 N per mm square, then the permissible stress in tension on a same section when the same welding is done in the field is Newton per mm square. Correct option B, 120 N per mm square. Question number 70, answer is B. Permissible stress in the welds are reduced by 20% when the welding is done in the field. Permissible stress in tension when welding is done in the field. Use this formula, 150 minus 150 into 20 divided by 100 equal to 150 minus 30. So correct option is 120 N per mm square. Option B. Question number 18. If the allowable compressive stress in continuous single angle strut is sigma AC, then what will be the allowable compressive stress in discontinuous single angle strut connected with one rivets? So correct option A, 0.8 sigma AC. Question number 18, answer is A. End condition, effective length KL, allowable axial compressive stress sigma AC. First one, for discontinuous members, for single rivet or bolt, effective length KL 1.L and allowable compressive stress 0.8 sigma AC. Second one, for double rivet or bolt and weld, effective length 0.85L and allowable compressive stress sigma AC. Second one, for continuous member, for single or double angle, effective length 0.70L to 0.85L and allowable axial compressive stress equal to sigma AC. Question number 90. What is the effective throat thickness value in case of complete penetration of the butt weld? Correct option A, thickness of thinner member jointed. Question number 90. Answer is A. Size of butt weld and effective throat thickness, TE. First one, for partially penetrated butt welds in case of single V, single U, single bevel butt joint, T equal to 5/8 thickness of thinner member. Second one, for fully penetrated butt welds in case of double V, double U and double bevel butt joint, equal to thickness of thinner members. So correct option A. Question number 20. As per limit state method of design of plate girders, if D upon TW less than 67 EW, then the plate girder is designed as. So correct option A, an ordinary beam. Question number 20, answer A. Limit state design as per IS code 800-2007, if D upon TW less than or equal to 67 epsilon W, when the plate girder is designed as ordinary beam, where epsilon W equal to under root of 250 upon FYW, where FYW equal to yield stress of web. So correct option A. Question number 21. Lacing bars in a steel column can have inclination between. Correct option D, 40 to 70 degrees. Question number 21. Answer D. Lacing bars in a steel column can have an inclination between 40 and 70 degrees. Question number 22. The term of block shear is associated with the design of. This question is asked to exam Kolhapur MNC 2017. Correct option A, steel tension member. Question number 22, answer A. Block shear is limited that should be accounted for during the design of steel tension members. This failure mechanism combines a tensile failure one plane and shear failure on a perpendicular plane. Correct option A. Question number 23. Horizontal stiffeners in steel plate girders are provided to safeguard against. This question is asked to exam WRD 2016. Correct option A. Compression buckling of web plate. Question number 24. Bearing stiffeners is provided at. Correct option C. Both A and B. Question number 24. Answer is C. Bearing stiffeners provide at the point of concentrated load and at support to resist reactions. These are provided to avoid local bending failure of the flange, local crippling and stiffener buckling of wave. The bearing stiffener together with wave plate stiffener shall be designed as column, effective length equal to 0.7 multiply actual length of stiffener. So correct option C. Question number 25. Maximum size of fillet weld for a plate of square edge is. Correct option A. 1.5 mm less than the thickness of plate. This question is asked to exam PWD 2016. Maximum size of fillet weld S max equal to for a square edge S max equal to thickness of thinner member minus 1.5 mm. Second one, for rounded toe of rolled section S max equal to 3/4 of the thickness of the section at the toe. Correct option 25A. Question number 26. The effective depth of a T-beam is the distance between the. Correct option B. Center of flange and top of the tensile reinforcement. This question is asked to exam Pune MNC 2016. Number 26. Answer is C. The effective depth of a T-beam is the distance between the top of flange and the center of tensile reinforcement. Question number 27. The maximum resistance against rotation is offered by the weld at a point. Right option C. Most distant. This question is asked to exam WRD 2016. 27. Answer C. The maximum resistance against rotation is offered by the weld at a point of most distant. Question number 28. If delta P is the maximum probable deviation of actual value from the computed value of strength P and delta F is the maximum probable deviation of actual value for the computed value of internal load F, then the maximum factor of safety is equal to. Correct option A. 1 plus delta F upon 1 minus delta P upon P. This question is asked to exam WRD 2016. Question number 28. Answer is A. Minimum FOS equal to 1 plus delta F upon 1 minus delta P upon P. So correct option A. Question number 29. If the permissible compressive stress for a concrete in bending is sigma CBC kg per meter square, the modular ratio is. Correct answer option C. 280 upon 3 sigma CBC. This question is asked to exam WRD 2016. Modular ratio equal to 280 upon 3 sigma CBC. Correct answer option C. Question number 30. The gap between web plates and flange plate for fillet weld should not be more than. Correct answer option D. 1.5 mm. This question is asked to exam Latur MNC 2016. Gap between web plates and flange plates for fillet weld should not be more than 1.5 mm. Correct option D. Question number 31. A continuous beam shall be shamed to be a deep beam if the ratio of its effective span to overall depth is. Correct answer option D. Less than 2.5. For deep beam, for a simply supported beam L upon D less than 2, and second one, continuous beam L upon D less than 2.5. So correct option D. Question number 32. Vertical construction joints are provided where the shearing forces are minimum in case of. Correct answer all of these. Slab, beams and girders. All of these. क्वेश्चन नंबर 33, द इफेक्टिव लेंथ ऑफ अ कॉम्प्रेशन मेंबर ऑफ लेंथ एल हेल्ड इन पोजीशन एंड रिस्ट्रेंड इन डायरेक्शन एट वन एंड एंड इफेक्टिवली रिस्ट्रेंड इन डायरेक्शन बट नॉट हेल्ड इन पोजीशन एट द अदर एंड इज राइट आंसर ऑप्शन ए 1.2 एल. क्वेश्चन नंबर 34, द ग्रेटर क्लियर डायमेंशन ऑफ अ वेब थिकनेस टी शुड नॉट एक्सीड. करेक्ट आंसर ऑप्शन डी नन ऑफ दिस. This question is asked to exam Parbhani MNC 2015. In web stiffeners, in number case, the greater clear dimension of a web panel less than 270 TW and lesser clear dimension of web panel less than 180 TW. So 34 correct answer option D. Question number 35, IS 800 refers to dash. Correct answer option A, Indian standard for steel design. This question is asked to exam PWD Nashik 2015. 35 answer is A. IS 800 Indian standard for a steel design which was published in 1984. The earlier revision of this standard was done in year 1984 and the latest revision of 2007 was released on 22 February 2008. It is written for use in India. So correct answer option A. Question number 36. What is the maximum slenderness ratio of steel column subjected to dead load and live load only? So correct option A, 180. Number 36. Answer is A. Serial number, type of members, maximum slenderness ratio. First one, for compression members which carry dead loads and superimposed loads, 180. Second one, for compression member which carry compressive load due to wind or seismic forces, only 250. Third one, for members carrying mainly tension in a roof truss or bracing system, 350. The last one, tension members other than pre-tensioned members, 350. So correct answer option A. Question number 37, which of the following does not describe a weld type? Correct answer option C, zigzag weld. First one, butt or groove weld. Second one, fillet or lap weld. Third one, slot weld. And the last one, plug weld. These all types of weld. Question number 37, answer is C. Question number 38, compression members are generally called. The right answer option A, struts. This question is asked to exam Parbhani MNC 2015. Number 38, answer is A, strut. The compression members in roof truss are truss boom and rafter. Second one, ties. The tension members are ties. Third one, purlins. A roof beam usually supported by a roof truss. It is a flexure member. So correct answer option A. Question number 39. A column splice is used to increase. Correct answer option A, length of the column. This question is asked to Nashik PWD 2015. Question number 39, answer is A, column splice. A joint is required in the height of column member in a multi-stored building frame is called column. It is used to increase length of column. Column splice are designed as a short column. Column splice are normally located at a section just above the floor level, H upon 4 from floor level. So correct answer option A. Question number 40. The shape of shear stress diagram for a square beam is? Correct answer option A, parabola. This question is asked to exam Nanded JHDPI 2014. Question number 41. Junction between the flange and web of a beam is known as? Correct answer option C, fillet. Number 41. Answer is C. Junction between flange and web of a beam is known as fillet. Flange, this term refers to the horizontal pieces on a beam. So correct option C. Question number 42. The greatest grip of long rivet shall not exceed. Correct option C, 8D. Question number 42. Answer is C. The greatest grip of long rivet shall not exceed 8D, where D equal to diameter of the holes. So correct option C. Question number 43. In a cantilever beam, the maximum deflection of the beam should not be greater than. Correct answer option A, 1 upon 180.
क्वेश्चन नंबर 43 आंसर इज ए. मैक्सिमम डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ बीम सब्जेक्टेड टू लाइव लोड फॉर फर्स्ट वन सिंपली सपोर्टेड बीम एलिमेंट सस्टेनेबल टू क्रैकिंग स्पैन अपॉन 360 एलिमेंट्स नॉट सस्टेनेबल टू क्रैकिंग स्पैन अपॉन 300 सेकेंड वन फॉर कैंटिलीवर एलिमेंट सस्पेक्टेबल टू क्रैकिंग इक्वल टू स्पैन अपॉन 180 एलिमेंट्स नॉट सस्पेक्टेबल टू क्रैकिंग स्पैन अपॉन 150 सो करेक्ट आंसर ऑप्शन ए. क्वेश्चन नंबर 44 द बीम सेक्शन हैज़ टू बी रीडिजाइंड इफ द शेयर स्ट्रेस एक्सीड्स द अलाउबल शेयर स्ट्रेस बाय करेक्ट आंसर ए 2 टाइम्स. क्वेश्चन नंबर 44 आंसर इज ए. द बीम सेक्शन हैज़ टू बी रीडिजाइंड इफ द शेयर स्ट्रेस एक्सीड्स द अलाउबल शेयर स्ट्रेस बाय 2 टाइम्स करेक्ट आंसर ए.
क्वेश्चन नंबर 45 इन अ बीम ऑफ रेक्टेंगुलर सेक्शन द रेशियो ऑफ मैक्सिमम शेयर स्ट्रेस टू एवरेज शेयर स्ट्रेस इज करेक्ट आंसर ऑप्शन सी 1.53. क्वेश्चन नंबर 45 आंसर इज सी. यूज दिस फॉर्मूला रेक्टेंगुलर सेक्शन ताउ मैक्स इक्वल टू 3/4 ताउ एवरेज ताउ मैक्स अपॉन ताउ एवरेज इक्वल टू 1.5 सो करेक्ट आंसर ऑप्शन सी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 46 द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द सेंटर्स ऑफ एडजेसेंट रिवेट्स इन द सेम रो इज कॉल्ड एज करेक्ट आंसर ऑप्शन ए पिच. क्वेश्चन नंबर 46 आंसर इज ए. फर्स्ट वन पिच डिस्टेंस बिटवीन सेंटर्स ऑफ टू कॉन्जेक्यूटिव रिवेट्स और बोल्ट्स मेजर्ड पैरेलल टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स इन द मेंबर लाइंग ऑन द सेम रिवेट्स और बोल्ट लाइन. सेकेंड वन लैप लैप जॉइंट इज दैट विच वन मेंबर इज प्लेस्ड अबव अदर एंड दे आर कनेक्टेड बाय मीन्स ऑफ रिवेट्स सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन ए. थर्ड वन गेज डिस्टेंस बिटवीन एडजेसेंट रिवेट्स लाइन और सेंटर टू सेंटर डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू कॉन्जेक्यूटिव रिवेट्स और बोल्ट्स मेजर्ड एट राइट एंगल्स to the direction of force. Fourth one staggered pitch. It is the distance measured along one rivet line from center of a rivet on it to the center the adjoining rivets on the adjacent parallel rivet line. So correct option A. Question number 47. A column splice is used to increase. Correct option A. Length of the column. Question number 47. Answer is A. Column splice. A joint is required the height of column member in a multi-storied building frame is called a column. Second one, it is used to increase length of column. Column splice are designed as a short column. Column splice are normally located at a section just above the floor level h/4 from floor level. Correct option A. Question number 48. Maximum size of fillet weld except in the case of weld applied to the round toe of steel section is determined. Correct option A by subtracting 1.5 mm from the thickness of thinner member. 48 answer is A. Maximum size of fillet weld S max for a square edge S max equal to thickness of thinner member minus 1.5 mm. Second one for rounded toe of rolled section S max equal to 3/4 of the thickness of the section at the toe. So correct option A. Question number 49. What is the maximum value of clear spacing of intermediate fillet weld in the case of tension member? This question is asked to exam WCD 2019. So correct option B 16T but in no case be more than 200 mm. Intermediate fillet weld when length of fillet weld required transmitting a force less than continuous fillet weld clear spacing between intermediate fillet weld should not more than 12T or 200 mm whichever is less for compression member, 60T or 200 mm whichever is less for tension member. Correct option B. Question number 50. The factor of safety for wind load in the design of high strength friction grip bolts is taken as. Correct option B 1.2. High strength friction grip bolts are made from bars of medium carbon heat treated steel. High tensile steel. Factor of safety for wind load in the design of high strength friction grip bolts equal to 1.2. Correct option B. In this video last question 51. If the width of flat used for lacing of compression member is 60 mm then what should be the nominal diameter of rivets to be used? Correct answer option C 20 mm. क्वेश्चन नंबर 51 आंसर इज सी. यूज दिस फॉर्मूला नॉमिनल डायमीटर ऑफ रिवेट इक्वल टू 1/3 इंटू विड्थ ऑफ प्लेट. पुट दिस वैल्यू इन दिस फॉर्मूला 60/3 इक्वल टू 20 mm. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन सी. Here this video is finished. I hope this video will be helpful for your exam, and for more latest update related to exam, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends. Thank you so much.